I'm 4 times as old as the last person who watched this video. And in 5 years, I'll be 3 times as old as she is then. How old am I now? Now, you could solve this problem by going and finding her, asking her age, and multiplying by 4. Good luck with that. She could be on the other side of the world. So you're going to have to find a better way to solve this problem. You'll probably start by assigning a variable. Now, you might think, hey, we'll assign a variable to how old I am now. Just let that be x. But then her age, I'm 4 times her age, so her age is going to be x over 4, and then you've got fractions. So instead, yeah, you might want to let the variable be her age now. So let x be her age now. Because by letting the variable be her age, then my age is just 4 times x, and we don't have any fractions. And that's nice. Now notice that I'm writing the now in here with my definition of the variable here. The now is very important because we're going to talk about our ages now and our ages in 5 years. And we want to be clear that the variable stands for her age now. So now let's try to set up an equation. In 5 years, my age is going to be 4x plus 5. Because I'll just be 5 years older than 4x. And we know that that's going to be equal to 3 times her age in 5 years. So this is going to be 3 times her age in 5 years is x plus the 5 years that have gone by. And there we go. We have an equation. And we know how to tackle this. We'll expand the right side first, and we'll have 4x plus 5 equals 3x plus 3 times 5 is 15. Then we isolate the variable. We'll subtract 3x from both sides. That'll leave us just an x over here, and the 3x is canceled on the right. Then we subtract 5 from both sides, and 15 minus 5 is 10. And if you just circle that as the answer, you'll be wrong. Question asks how old I am. I'm certainly not 10 years old. My age now is 4 times 10 is 40. Yeah, I'm old. Now we can check our answer. My age is 4 times her age. Sure enough, if I'm 40 and she's 10, I'm 4 times as old as she is. In 5 years, I'll be 45, she'll be 15. I'll be 3 times as old as she is then. So how old am I now? Oh, I'm 40. All right, let's move on to a less depressing problem. We've got a basketball team here at Art of Problem Solving. We're not very good. We're so bad that I'm the team's best player, and you just saw how old I am. And if you watch the fractions videos, you know how short I am too. So we're pretty bad. We've only won 2 of our first 17 games. Now, we'd like to be respectable. I figure we win 2/5 of our games, that's respectable. So I want to know how many games we have to win in a row so we can get up to respectable, get up to where we've won 2/5 of our games. So here, well, we'll let W be our variable for wins in a row. Wins in a row, and we need to figure out how many we'll win in a row. Now, if we just start winning a bunch of games in a row, we win W in a row, we'll have won 2 plus W games total. And we want that to be 2/5 of the total. So we want this to be 2/5 of the total. The total will be 17 plus all these games that we're winning in a row. So there's our equation. We know how to solve this. First, we'll knock out the fraction. We'll multiply both sides by 5. Over here on the left, we'll have 5 times 2 plus w, and over here on the right, we're multiplying by 5 to knock out the denominator, get rid of our fraction. The 5's over here, sure enough, as planned, they'll cancel out. Over here on the left, we'll distribute. 5 times 2 is 10, plus 5 times w. Over there, the 5's have canceled, and we're left with 2 times the w plus 17 over there, and we'll distribute that out as well. 2 times 17 is 34. 2 times w is just 2w. Once again, we isolate the variable. We'll subtract 2w from both sides. We'll be left with 3w over here. And we'll subtract the 10 from both sides. 34 minus 10 is 24. Then we divide by 3. And we see that we need to win 8 games in a row. And just to check that answer, if we win 8 in a row, we'll have 10 wins. And we'll have played 17 plus 8 is 25 games. 10 out of 25. That's 2/5 of our games, and we'll be respectable. So all we have to do now is hire some tall mathematicians.